Yes, I did.
So that we will not make a mistake in our lives. We don't know when we are dying. We don't know when our Lord Jesus Christ will appear. Therefore, it is very important that we study this this topic very well. So that we will not do any mistakes in our Christian journey. Yesterday, we read a scripture in the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 6. From 14 all the way to 18. And the Lord spoke to us about coming out from among them. Brethren, there are so many things that the Lord wants me and you to come out from. The Lord also made us know that so many people portray themselves as Christians. But yet, they are still doing what the world is doing. What the Lord wants me and you to come out from, that is what they are still doing. And yet, they are in churches. And they call themselves Christians. So this evening we are going to find out, we are going to continue where we stopped. And then to go into this brother. So that we will know some of the things that we don't have to get ourselves involved. Amen.
Amen.
So 2 Corinthians, we are still in 2 Corinthians chapter 7. This time we are going to chapter 7. The verse
1.
Chapter
7,
the verse
1. Okay. Say you was out washing tea. Say you was out washing tea. Out of four. Oh, my young warrior won't improve when I'm your feeling. I am really a hot tear on your Amen.
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 This is what the Bible is telling me and you tonight. He says, because of this promise. What promise did the Lord promise us? The Lord promised us to come out from among them. The Lord promised us to be separate.
Amen.
The Lord also promised us not to touch an unclean thing. If we do this, then he will take us as sons and daughters. So this is the promise the Lord has promised us. We are getting rid of all these things because of this promise. We want God to call us sons and daughters. If the Lord is saying sons and daughters, then what about those who are disobedient to the Lord? What about those who believe that what the Bible is saying is not true? What about those who have been disobedient unto the Lord. It means that these people cannot be called sons and daughters. Because they still have all these things that the Lord hates on them. Is the Lord communicating to me and you? So if we study this teachings very carefully, we will get to know that it is not everyone who says, Lord, Lord, is really the children of God. But those who does the things of the Lord. Those who obeys the Lord. Those who walks on the ways of the Lord. Those are the people that the Lord can call sons and daughters. Amen.
Amen.
Are we understanding this very clearly? So the Bible is saying this. If we can come out from among them, why is the Lord saying come out from among them? It means they are doing something that the Lord hates. They are doing something that the Lord doesn't want. That is why the Lord wants those who want to stand for Him to come out from whatever error or whatever sin that these unbelievers are partaking. So that the promise that the Lord has promised that we will be sons and daughters of Him will come to pass in our lives. If we become sons and daughters of God, then it is connecting us to Jesus Christ told the apostles that I go to prepare a place for you. In my Father's house are so many mansions. And I go to prepare a place for you. When I am done, I will come back and collect you with me. And where I am, there you shall be also. So this scripture is also a promise. But this promise is there for those whom the Lord can call sons and daughters. So 2 Corinthians chapter 7, 1 is telling us that therefore, having these promises, beloved, let us cleanse ourselves from all filthiness. Amen.
Amen.
Having these promises, being told us about all these things that the Lord would do for His children, then let us be in a hurry to cleanse ourselves. Because number one, the Lord has said we should come out from among them. It means we are doing something that the unbelievers are also doing. And the Lord cannot accept us if we cannot change or come out or stop what we are doing.
Nah,
Amen. Is the Lord communicating? So because of all these promises that the Lord has promised, I have so many mansions, and I will come and collect you, and I will take you as a son and daughters. All these promises are good. But one thing we need to do to get hold of this promise, it is for me and you to cleanse ourselves from all filthiness. Glory be to Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Filthiness, Efi. Anything that the Lord hates, anything that the Lord doesn't want to have a look to, it becomes dirty. It becomes filthy. It becomes unclean. Amen. So before the Lord will accept us as children, we have to be sure that we are not partaking in these things. We have to come out from it. Coming out from it, we are coming out from among them. We are separating ourselves. Why are we separating ourselves? Because we want to be the children of God.
Amen.
Glory be to Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Why is the Lord separating us from among them? Because he wants to take us to his kingdom. Why is the Lord want us to separate? Because he wants his judgment to come upon the disobedient children. Is the Lord communicating to me and you this evening? So I want us to know that we have a task to do. And this task is to come out from everything that is not of God. If it is not of God, then it is of the world. That is why the Lord says we should not love the world. Because the world that we love is passing away. And it is going with the things in it. The more we love the world, the more we get in contact with the things in the world. So this is what the Lord is saying. We need to make sure that we come out from all these things if we want to be called children of God. Glory be to Jesus.
Hallelujah.
So he says, let us cleanse ourselves from all filthiness of the flesh. Filthiness of the flesh. He's talking about the dirty things that we put on this body. The dirty things that we use this body to do. Amen.
Amen.
And there are so many things that the Lord doesn't want that we put on this body. Some of them are making ups, jewelries, wearing trousers as a woman, dressing in a way to expose yourselves. Amen. Saying things that are not of God. Blasphemy against the Lord. And so many of them. All these things are things that are filthy. And we find out that we put on the body, or it comes out to defile the body. You can see someone very nice, very presentable man, presentable woman, but when they open their mouth to speak, that word will come and defile the body. Glory be to Jesus.
Hallelujah.
And these are some of the things that the Lord wants me and you to come out from. He continued to say that filthiness of the spirit. No. Filthiness of the spirit. There are some people, you see them that they have cleansed themselves. But in the spiritual realm, things that you cannot see with your eyes is fighting against them.
Amen.
And some of these things are the speech, the character that comes out from a man. It proceeds straight from the heart. When that speech has not been spoken, you will see that person very holy. But the moment that mouth is open, the word that comes out from that mouth defiles the holiness of the body that you see. The character that they will show, it tells you and defile the holiness of the body. So therefore, the Lord wants every child of Him to make sure that we cleanse our inside, things that are proceeding from the heart. If an unbeliever will fight outside, a believer should not do that. If an unbeliever will insult someone, a believer should not do that. If an unbeliever will show some kind of disrespect, a believer should not do that. So, these are the things that we don't see with our eyes, but it comes out in action and defiles our body. And the Bible is telling us that we should cleanse ourselves from all filthiness of the flesh, filthiness of the spirit. If we want Him to call us His children, because all these things that we are doing are the things that the world is also doing. So if we have come out from the world and now wants to follow Christ, our lives have to change. So you continue to say, the moment we can cleanse our hearts, the things that proceed, and also cleanse our bodies, the things that we put on ourselves, then we are perfecting holiness in the fear of the Lord. Amen. It is a niema ewo ye mu no se ye jai ni ye jai niema so a ewo ye hu na mu ania enye na ye kronkron ye no ye ma na sipi ewo nyame suro mu.
Amen.
Amen. In the fear of the Lord. Why in the fear of the Lord? Because the Lord wants us to be his children. The Lord has made us know his judgment. He has made us know that the world is truly passing away. Therefore, with fear of these things, with fear of this God, we have to start cleansing ourselves. The flesh and the spirit. So that we walk towards holiness. And these things are being done. They are being done because of the fear of God. So if you are not ready to change, then you don't fear God. And that is another thing for another time. It takes you back to the unbelievers. Because they are disobedient to God. Is the Lord communicating to me and you tonight? Secondly, the Lord is also telling us that we don't belong here on earth. So many people have made this world their home. So they are busy acquiring things of the world. They are busy doing the things that will benefit them here on earth. But the Bible has told us several times that we are strangers here on earth. Whether we like it or not, we are strangers. The one who brought us says we are strangers. Therefore, we need to accept that. Let us look at this in the book of 1 Peter chapter 2. First Peter chapter 2. Let us read from the 10.
Amen. Amen. More paneno. Moya or mine. Not a fair, moya young or mine. Moa, munya, mobu. Not a fair, dear. Moya, mobu.
Amen.
Amen.
Who once were not a people? But are now the people of God. We were once not a people. Because anyone and enter into her. Therefore, those people cannot stand. They will wither and die off. So the Lord is saying that we were once those people. We were also disobedient people. And the Lord has called us to Himself. And because of the grace of God, we have now become people. Amen.
Amen.
Who had not obtained mercy, but now have obtained mercy. We that were not having mercy. But now we have obtained one. Because of Jesus Christ. We were now given the chance to come to the Lord. So that we can be called children of God. Amen.
Amen.
So this is where we were proceeding from. We were all heading to destruction. Because of the unbelief and the disobedient spirit in us. Because of this unbelief and disobedient spirit, there are so many things that we were doing that God hates. And the Lord had compassion and mercy upon us. Gave them the option to become His children. And we took that opportunity and ran to the Lord. And because of this, the Lord has promised us that when we come out from this people and change ourselves, we are going to be called children of Him. So now we belong to a different group. We belong to a different kingdom. We are now a different people. A people of the Lord. We now belong to the kingdom of God. There is difference between us and the unbelievers out there. Because we have crossed from death to life. Our master is different now. And so our kingdom is different. If our kingdom is different, then where we are heading to is different. So this makes us strangers here on earth. Is the Lord communicating? So the thing is saying, who once were not a people, but are now the people of God, who had not obtained mercy, but now have obtained mercy. Beloved, I beg you as sojourners and pilgrims, abstain from fleshly lust, which war against the soul. Amen.
Amen.
Now we have become strangers. We have become aliens. Because we don't live for the body again. Remember, anyone who lives for the body will perish. We now live for the spirit. So we are now a soul that is living towards the kingdom of heaven. So we need to know that we are now strangers of this world. If we are strangers, then we don't have anything to do with fleshly things. Because it is this fleshy things that we have let go. It is this fleshy lust that we have pushed away. Amen.
Amen.
Why? Because the flesh war against the soul. Glory be to Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Read that 12, please. Amen. So because we are not the people of God, the Lord wants us to be very careful with our lives. We should make sure that we will not do what they do. We will not dress the way they dress. We will not sit where they sit. Because our kingdom is different. Our rules and regulations is now different. As we live among the Gentiles, we are now the children of God. We are not Gentiles anymore. But we live with them. And there are so many spies. There are so many people that are looking to us, praying that we will fall. Praying that we will do something that will scatter us. Glory be to Jesus.
Hallelujah.
These are the people that the Lord, because of them, we should play our Christian life very well. So that when they come in our midst, they will not have anything evil to speak about us. They will see the glorious way that we are walking on. They will indeed know that we have cleansed our hearts and our bodies. And then they will glorify the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
That is why the Lord have said that he is going to save us. So that the remaining ones will be pure. God is not fighting for quantity. He is fighting for quality. If we are 10, very cleansed, going to heaven, Lord appreciate that. Then we will be thousands and all will push to hell. Is the Lord communicating? So the Lord wants us to be different. Because we have now became, strangers of this world. Glory be to Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Now, because we have become strangers, There are so many things that these people that belong here on earth will do to us. Because we have now become strangers. We live on this earth, but we are not from this earth. So the people that this world is for them are there. And they will make strangers very sad. So they will do anything to your life. That is why the Lord is letting us know the state of our Christianity. So that if anything comes your way, you know who you are. Let us see this in the book of John, chapter 17. The verse 16. Amen. Let me start from the 14 so we understand it very well. Precious, please.
Okay. Yohane asempa, eti dun so, di chemu dunai, eradi asemunye, medi wasem mama won, ne wiase atane won ifreshe, won fri wiase, sedi amen so min fri wiase no, edunun, men srese, ni won fri wiase, ne mum se, ni won fri abone fo no hun si.
Amen.
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 This is what the Lord is telling me and you tonight. This is the prayer Jesus Christ prayed for us. We are now strangers. Now, we don't owe anything here on earth. Everything that you have is borrowed. You will give it up one day. So the Bible says, John chapter 17, 14, I have given them your word, and the world has hated them because they are not of the world, just as I am not of the world. Anyone who follows Jesus closely and are doing the things of Jesus Christ, this person is not of the world. Amen.
Amen.
So he's saying this because he wants us to know. So that when you see two people gathered somewhere speaking about you, you will know that you are a stranger. When you see three people planning against your life, then you know you are a stranger. Amen.
Amen.
So he says, he has given us his word. What is his word? His word is that we should not love the world. If we love the world, the love of the Father, the love of Jesus Christ is not in us. This is the word that have entered our spirit. If the love of this world is in our heart, we don't have the love of the Father. So this is the word Jesus Christ has given to us. So he says, I gave them my word, and the world hated them. Do you know that when you try to love the two masters and you try to love one and ignore the other one that you don't love becomes, you become their enemy. So as our love has shifted from the world to Christ, now the world has become enemy to us. So it is because of the love of Jesus that this world are now hating us. If you let the love of Jesus go now, automatically you gain the love of the world and you will be okay.
Amen.
So because we have let all this thing go and we are now following the footsteps of the Lord, the world has now turned to be our enemy. Why is the world our enemy? Because Jesus Christ was also their enemy. So anyone who follows the footsteps and do the work and the things of Jesus Christ, automatically, you also become the enemy of the world. And if you become the enemy of the world, then you will know that you are the children of God. Amen.
Amen.
So the Lord wants us to know this so that we will not take it to heart when we see the world mocking us. We will not take it to heart when we see the world insulting us. We will not take it to heart when we see the world preventing our ways. Is the Lord communicating to me and you tonight? You need to know what you stand for. You need to know that you are for Christ. And therefore, so many things will happen to you as long as we still live here on earth. Don't forget there are so many. Don't forget we came out from somewhere. We were all together. But we were obedient and hear the word of Lord, and then we came out from among them. And that obedience that we have made, that obedience, it's the reason why they are treating us this way. Our Lord Jesus Christ was also obedient to his Father. And he was treated the same way. So as we are also obedient to Jesus Christ, we will be also be treated the same way. So this is what the Lord wants me and you to know. From now on, don't compare yourself to those people anymore. Because we are from a different place altogether. Even though we all live here on earth. Glory be to Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
So he says, and the world has hated them because they are not of the world, just as I am not of the world. 15. I do not pray that you should take them out of the world. This prayer world now. But rather, protect them from the evil one.
Amen.
That is why so many arrows will be thrown on you, but you will still stand. The protection of the Lord is still upon our lives as children of God. So the arrows will come from the world, left and right. The Lord has been instructed not to take you out, but prevent you from Satan. Why is he preventing us from Satan? Preventing us in a way Satan cannot kill us. But the arrows will come. But the Lord will give us the strength to stand them.
Amen.
Glory be to Jesus.
Hallelujah.
This is what the Lord is telling us. So, brother, sister, not loving the world is a very big issue in Christianity. If we will love the world, they don't have any problem with us. Because we are all flowing together. We all drink alcohol together. We all smoke together. Gone by the days, we all take girlfriends together. They expose themselves, we also expose ourselves. But now they expose you cover. And you think they will not hate you. They will hate you. Because Satan is using them. Is the Lord communicating? The Lord wants me and you to continue to be here. So that our character might change them. So that the word that proceeds from our mouth, some of them will hear and come out also. That is the reason why we still exist here on earth. If not, when you become born again, you do the things of the Lord, maybe the Lord sees that you are suffering a lot, he takes you out. But the Lord has to leave us here so that I and you will be example for them. Maybe they can also change. Is the Lord communicating to me and you tonight? So, brethren, this is what the Lord wants us to know. As we have come out from among them, we are not done yet.
Okay, we are not done yet.
They will fight back.
Oh,
they will. Because they are being used by Satan. They are being programmed by Satan. And Satan has programmed them in a way that they should pursue those who have managed to come out from among them. If you do the same thing with them, you don't have a problem. But when your life started changing, trust me, there is going to be a big problem at hand. That is why when you start speaking the truth as a preacher, no one loves you. It is not their fault. It is Satan influencing them. Because they have availed themselves for Satan to use. And Satan will use them proper. So that the mission of our Lord will not be accomplished. Now we know where we came from. We know how the Lord has called us. We know that the Lord said we should not love the world. We also know that if we do not love the world, automatically we become an enemy to the world. We also know that as we have come out from among them, we are now strangers. Even the house we live in now is not for you, it's for them. That is why when the rapture occurred, they will take in charge of everything here on earth. Because we are now strangers. So let us behave as strangers. Let us continue to do the things of the Lord. Our God will never put us to shame. As we have put in everything of our lives and focusing on the Lord alone, Jesus will not put us to shame. He will make sure He saves us. And we will enter into His kingdom with joy.
Amen.
Those who will overcome, they will sit on my throne. As I have also overcame, and I sit on my Father's throne. May the Lord bless all of us. May He help us to continue to be humble. May He help us to continue to know who we are. May we be very active in our prayer. And may we also walk on the ways of the living God. Don't let your character change because of some unbeliever out there. Continue to walk on the ways of the Lord. Their time will come very soon. And you will see them no more. May the Lord bless His word. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Let us quickly open our mouth and thank the Lord for the word He has given to us. Let us quickly thank the Lord. Open your mouth and thank the Lord. If you can unmute yourself, unmute yourself and let us thank the Lord together. Open your mouth, Father, we thank You for Your word. Lord, we bless You for Your word in the name of Jesus. The word that You have given to us, we thank You. Father, we thank You. Father, we thank You. Father, we thank You in Jesus' mighty name. Lord, we thank You. Lord, we thank You. Lord, we thank You in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank You for Your word. Father, we thank You for Your word in the mighty name of Jesus. Your word that You have given to us, we thank You, Lord. We thank You, Lord. We thank You, Lord. We thank You, Lord. Somebody open your mouth and thank the Lord. Open your mouth and thank the Lord in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank You. Lord, we thank You. Lord, we thank You. Lord, we thank You in Jesus' name. Father, we thank You. We thank You for Your way. Lord, we thank You for Your way. Father, we thank You for Your way. Lord, we thank You for Your way. In the name of Jesus, Your word that You have given to us, we thank You. We bless You. Father, we thank You. We bless You in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Amen. Let us continue to pray that may the Lord help us in a way that our character will not change, regardless of what anyone will do to distract our lives. Open your mouth and pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we continue to pray. Lord, help us. Lord, help us. Lord, help us. Lord, help us. Establish us in the name of Jesus. Establish us so our character will not change. Our character will not change. Not because of what the world will do to our lives. We will not change. We will stand firm in the name of Jesus. We will stand firm in the name of Jesus. We will not change. We will not change. We will not change in the name of Jesus. We will continue to stand firm. We will continue to do the things of the Lord. We will continue to walk on the way. We will continue to humble ourselves in the name of Jesus. Lord, we thank you. We bless you. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Let us also pray. We want the Lord to equip us so that when it comes to the things of the Lord, we will not be easily to convince. We also pray that may the Lord help us so that we will not blaspheme him because of anything that we hear. May the Lord continue to help us so that we will continue to humble ourselves before him. In the name of Jesus, let us pray. Let us pray. Father, we pray in the name of Jesus. Father, help us in Jesus' mighty name so we can humble ourselves unto you, Lord. Father, we don't want to be easily to be convinced. We pray in the name of Jesus. Father, help us so we will not be easily to convince. Help us to grow. Help us to grow in you in the name of Jesus. Father, help us in the mighty name of Jesus. Help us to stand firm in Jesus' name. Help us to stand firm in Jesus' name. Help us to stand firm in the name of Jesus. Father, we pray. Help your children to stand firm. Help us to stand firm. Help us to stand firm. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Now we are praying our last prayer. We have seen that what brings Christians down is lack of maturity. If a Christian will fall, it is because of lack of maturity. We are praying for the Lord to make us grow. Grow in the spirit. Somebody can even have a dream about someone, and if you are not a mature Christian, you will stand on that dream and misbehave. Forgetting that Satan can also reveal. Forgetting that Satan can appear as an angel of light. If we are not matured, our head will be joined together and we will be cracking our heads together. What I know and believe is that our God is not an author of confusion. So anywhere you see confusion approaching, the Spirit of God is not there. Anytime you had a dream that would bring confusion, the Spirit of God is not in that. So we are going to pray that may the Lord help us to be matured in him, so that we will not just be convinced and deceived and be toasted here and there, just like that. But we will be matured in our Christian lives, because our souls and the souls of others are concerned. Let us open our mouth and pray for maturity. Father, in the name of Jesus, I continue to pray. Father, help me to grow. Help me to be a mature Christian in the name of Jesus. Help me to be a mature Christian in the mighty name of Jesus. Help me to be a mature Christian in the name of Jesus. Any confusions, any distractions, Father, we come against it in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, we come against it in Jesus' name. We come against it in Jesus' name. We come against it in Jesus' name. We come against it in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you. Lord, we bless you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
May the Lord bless all of us for coming.
Amen.